superstar has all the tools needed to win this one. Now let's see if he can put them together. Here we go, guys. This is going to be great.
What's up, guys, and welcome back to TWF League match. This is actually my first league match I've uploaded to my channel. My first actual league match you can see, actually. I have a few videos, I never uploaded them, I never put commentary or anything on them. But this is my first video, and it's going to be a new series on my channel. I'm going to upload my TWF league match every week. Anyways, this is a feud that's been going on for quite a while now. Tyson Frost and Robert Blake. It's been going on for over a month and it's going to climax tonight. It's a really good match. But before we even start, really, I want to tell you that the lag in this match is terrible. I really do not know why it lags so much. I actually had a match with Tyson Frost in a tag team match last week, I think. And that match was fine. Basically, no lag at all. But in this match, for some fucking reason, it lagged like fuck, and it made the match go on a lot longer than what it was supposed to, so I apologize beforehand, but I'll try to bring you up to date on what's actually happening in our feud. Anyways, Robert Blake was the younger brother of Ryan Blake, and Ryan Blake is the leader of the Saviors. It's a group in TWF that debuted, I think they debuted kind of this year, but not really, because Ryan Blake has been there for quite a while and kind of started this gimmick last year, at the end of last year's league. But anyways, this is his younger brother Robert Blake, and he's in a match with Tyson Frost, because Ryan Blake kind of chose Tyson Frost. He wanted to save Tyson Frost, which is kind of crazy in own sense of the word, because he just wants to take Tyson Frost's soul, basically. It's really weird. He wants to save him. It's all that talk and everything. But anyways, he's put Robert Blake in a match with Tyson Frost. And to be honest, Tyson Frost just wants to rip Robert Blake's heart out, because what Robert Blake has done to Tyson Frost is crazy. Like, last week, he basically attacked his wife in this actual cell. He broke her neck and everything. It was really, really crazy. Robert Blake is just doing everything because his brother tells him to. And Tyson Frost actually injured Ryan Blake with a bloody truck of all things. He fucking broke his leg pieces. Smashed his leg up pretty bad. But clearly Ryan was really pissed off that he did this, and he basically kidnapped his wife, you know? He kidnapped his wife. The Saviors kidnapped his wife, and last week, like I said, Robert Blake basically broke her up really, really badly. But anyways, as you can see in this match, Tyson Frost is just like, he's killing Robert. Robert hasn't got any offense in at all, because he can. Like, Tyson's like full of rage right now. He won't let him get any offense in. He's just literally beating the living crap out of him, which is understandable considering that Robert Blake basically killed his wife last week. It's really crazy. You should actually go read it. It was really fun doing that promo. But anyways, here comes Tyson with the chair, and oh, chair shot. That hurt. Fucking imagine that. But anyways, Tyson Frost is putting in the middle of the rope there. And he's going to go on attack again. Here we go. What's he going to do? But anyways, this feud is bloody awesome. I love them doing this feud. It's fucking great, actually. It's really my first actual feud I enjoyed. But oh, look at that kick right in the head. And as you can see, the lag is terrible already. And I really don't know why the lag was that bad. But Tyson's getting pumped up. Oh, Robert back up. Is he going to get any offense in? Nope. No offense in at all. That was a waste of a comeback. But anyways, Tyson basically killing him. He doesn't want to give him any offense at all. Tyson just wants to murder Robert Blake in a cell. That's as simple as it gets. I don't know if he's going to get that far, because this is a PG show, but you never know. But anyways, right into the chair. Ouch, that has to hurt. Robert Blake has to be really badly broke up right now. Robert Blake doesn't have a clue where he is, to be honest. Robert Blake is half dead right now, so you can't really expect him to know what he's doing. But kind of ripped Robert Blake, because that hurt. Anyways, Tyson Frost, he's up on the top rope. Don't even know what's happening here. He's not jumping off. He's not doing anything. Maybe he's just like looking at Robert Blake, thinking he's dead. But Robert Blake just gets back up. And botch. Big botch there. I don't know what happened, Tyson, here. But anyways, Robert Blake finally takes control. Up on the rope. And Tyson Frost comes flying down. That had to hurt. Anyways, Robert's finally in control for the first time in this whole match, basically. I don't know what happened to Tyson there. He probably got a little overwhelmed. He probably was thinking about ripping Robert's head off or something. Understandably, obviously. But anyways, he messed up really badly there. He shouldn't have done that, because he would have won this match if he keeps going on, like, on that attack. He would have won by now already, but you know, shit happens, I guess. Anyways, Robert is on control now. He's completely kicking the shit out of Tyson. Simple as it is, he's just kicking the shit out of him. Anyways, oh, what's this? He's on attack again. Oh, knee right in the back. That had to hurt. Man, this is actually quite a fun match. I'm not gonna lie, it was really a fun match, but the lag is just terrible. I didn't enjoy the lag at all. Lag is always terrible, but this is like some of the worst lag I've ever seen in it. It's the worst lag I've gotten in WWE 2K16, but back in WWE 2K14, you know, those six-man Elimination Chamber matches, they were way laggier than this, but this is definitely the worst lag I've had all year. As you can see, it's Hell in a Cell. This was the match of choice, basically. We decided that we want a Hell in a Cell match literally at the start of the feud, so. And it was kind of perfect, because the GM made the pay-per-view this month Hell in a Cell, so clearly a good climax. But anyways, I should actually get to you that the terms of these matches, because on the contract signing there was actual terms, Anyways, I'll get to the terms now. If Robert Blake loses, the Saviors, Robert Blake and Ryan Blake, will leave WWE. Basically, just did I just say WWE? What's WWE? WWE is not even real. We'll leave TWF. Anyways, and if Tyson Frost loses, he will actually join the Saviors. He will literally have to join the Saviors. He will have to be a Savior, and that's like their mission. You know, that's what they wanted. Can they succeed at their mission tonight? Who knows? But anyways, and there is actually another term. If Tyson Frost actually loses, he will not be able to see his wife again. That was just thrown in there last minute. I thought it would be a great addition. It wasn't that great, obviously, but I just thought it'd be a little fun. I was kind of bored, so I just added that in. So if Tyson loses, he has to join the Saviors, and he will never be able to see his wife again as long as he is a Savior. So as long as he's a Savior, he won't be able to see his wife again, or his actual kid who isn't born yet. So, yeah, the wife was pregnant, so you can hate on Robert Blake if you want. Well, that was a big move right there, and Tyson actually got out of the way. So Tyson should get on the offense right now, because it would be a smart idea, considering that Robert has controlled this match probably for the last, I don't know, 10 minutes. But he misses, obviously, because Robert's just too good. Well, not really, but he's going to go on attack again, obviously. What's he doing now? Going for a net breaker or something. So yeah, as you can see, this feud is very intense. It's like a bloodthirsty feud actually. So yeah, a lot of attacks have been going on, everything. Robert and Tyson actually cost Robert a match before with Blackjack or something, but I don't really want to talk about that again because that match didn't go down well. But anyways, Robert's still on attack. He's basically beating the living crap out of Tyson right now, which is kind of sad because the fans want Tyson to overcome the odds. But reversal. He hasn't reversed, man. Oh, that's just mean. Don't do that, Tyson. PG. Don't do that. You're not allowed to do that. But anyways, Tyson's actually getting some offense in again. They're just staring at each other, and Robert Robert's on the offense again, actually. I'm not too sure what they're doing there. I think they're staring at each other, and Robert actually said, "You're going to be a part of us," or something. And clearly that kind of pissed Tyson off a little bit. So Tyson was kind of overwhelmed again, because Robert just said, "You're going to be one of us." So yeah, that's inside info right there. But anyways, Robert is taking Tyson outside the ring. Whoa, this is actually quite intense. Don't hurt each other, obviously. Why would you want to hurt? Oh, wait. Robert just proved he can fly. Did you see how far he went? And he's not the smallest guy either. He's kind of strong, really. But he's not the biggest guy either. He can do a lot. But he just proved that he could fly there. He really proved it. Anyways, they're both outside the ring. Very dangerous, really. That cell can really fuck you up really badly. But anyways, Robert throwing Tyson into the cell. Nope, kind of missed. Oh, no. Robert, I told you not to go outside the ring, you idiot. But bang, right into the cell. I told you, his face is going to be fucked up. He's going to need plastic surgery now. That was really stupid. Robert, I really did tell you not to do that. But what's going to happen here? Oh, something big. Something big is going to happen here. Right into the cell. Oh, no. Please don't do this. Don't do this, Tyson. Come on. Don't do it. Ah, rest in peace. Tyson just basically threw suplexed Robert Wright through that cell. Quite a crazy move. Like, can you imagine how much strength that took to actually put Robert Blake through that bloody steel? Robert Blake has to be broken in half right now. How is he going to fight back? How is he going to do anything? I told you that Tyson wanted to kill Robert, and that's what's happening tonight. He wants to actually kill Robert Blake. And he's kind of proven that he can do it, because Robert's kind of broken in half right now. But anyways, they're fighting outside the ring right next to the announcers with me there in the middle. Yep, I'm over there, obviously. Because how could I be doing this? Duh. But anyways, Tyson's on attack again. Angle slam, kind of. Anyways, it's an interesting match, to be honest. I don't know, it wouldn't be one of the best matches I've ever played, but it was a fun match. But did you see that move? Like, come on, that was like a GTS. It was almost a GTS, and then he just throws him over and just kicks him right in the head. That was just crazy. But anyways, Robert is dead again. Like, how many times can Robert die? He is the Archangel, so he'll keep getting up, obviously, but Robert is actually getting it quite bad in this match. Robert Blake is actually running away from Tyson Frost. He's getting up that cell. He's actually running away. That is a first. That really is a first for me. But anyways, as you can see, that Tyson pretty much controlled this whole match. There was that period of time that Robert was controlling the match, but not anymore. Tyson's up there. But look at that stare down. Tyson basically just said, "You can't get away from me anymore. You can't. You're going to die up here." But oh, what a super kick. A super kick on top of the cell. Jesus Christ. Robert, if I were you, I'd be careful up here, because, you know, I don't think Tyson will think twice about throwing you off the damn thing. So yeah, please, be careful, Robert. You don't need this. You really don't need this, you know. You could just go home and live with your wife and kids if you have any. But anyways, Tyson's on attack. What's he doing? Oh, he went for his signature reversed. Oh, look at this. Robert's going to try to put him through the cell, obviously. He loves trying to put him through the cell, actually. He wants to put Tyson through the cell. Like, both these men want to kill each other. Obviously, Tyson will have that claim that he really has a right to try and kill him. But, you know, I don't know about Robert. Robert just seems like an evil man, to be honest. But anyways, Tyson getting pumped up again. Looking to get his signature, I guess. And Robert is kind of dead again, obviously. What's this? He's going to go for a move. Any move? Any move at all? He's bringing him up. Bringing him up. Is he going to do that again? Yep, that kick to the head. That fake GTS too. And he ends up doing that kick to the head. That's actually quite a cool move. Is an interesting move, I say indeed. Oh, what's that? He's going to try to throw him off the cell. He's just going to try to throw him off the cell. I can just tell you right now, he's going to try to throw him off the cell. Clearly, that's what he wants to do. He wants to kill Robert Blake tonight. He might really succeed at killing Robert Blake. Who knows? Who knows? What's he going to do now? Is this a sig? I can't really see if he has a sig right now. What's this? Ooh. No, off the cell. Wait, what? Yep, that hurt. He didn't fall off the cell for some reason. That man. You can really tell there that Robert is an Archangel, because that has to be some out of this world powers to not fall off the cell that time. Whoa! What, did you see those punches? Those fast fucking punches. That really hurt. That was his sig, by the way, so he has a finisher. We both have finishers, I think. Anyways, Tyson's just staring at him. Oh, what's this? Oh, he's going to aim up for a cutter. The cutter. What is it? The frostbite. The frostbite. Oh, frostbite. Right on top of the cell. Oh, he's dead. He's completely dead. He's completely dead. Anyways, if you're wondering what the frostbite is, that's the name of his move, is a cutter. That's his finisher. But what is this? What's he going to do now? Like, he's doing, like, just go for the pin. Like, bring him down and go for the pin and you win. Like, that's what you want to do. You want to win the match. Like I said, he doesn't want to win the match then. He wants to kill him. And no. Oh, no, 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 no. 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 Did you see that? Robert. Rest in pepperonis. He's dead. He's actually dead. What can we do now, eh? Tyson, you just killed your opponent. How can you even win the match now? Are you just going to jump down and pin him? Come on, Tyson. I thought better of you. You don't kill your opponent. There's no need for that. Really no need. But anyways, Robert Blake isn't dead somehow. As I said, he's an angel. He keeps getting up. He just keeps getting up. And as you can see in Robert's face, he's full of rage right now. He knows if he keeps doing this, Tyson will win and Tyson will probably kill him. So he needs to get under attack, which he's actually doing now. So a weird kind of stunner. I don't actually know what that move was. I don't even remember putting that on him. But anyways, it was a stunner. But now Robert's under attack. Clearly, Robert knows if he keeps doing this, he's going to die. But look at this. He's going to try to put him through the cell. And oh, he actually broke it a little bit. So that's what Robert's plan is now. He's full of rage. He knows if he keeps doing this, he's going to die. And look at this. He's going for his finisher. Nope, not going for his finisher. He's just getting him up easier. But anyways, what's this? What's he going to do? He's going to put him through his cell. Nope. All right. As you can see, he's trying to put him through this cell, but he's trying to be careful leaving his knees up so he doesn't get hurt either. Like, Robert's a smart man. Remember that. He's a smart wrestler. But anyways, what's this? He's going to try putting through the cell again, obviously. But nope, not again.
Clearly.
Anyways, as I said, Robert is full of rage right now. He knows if he continues, Tyson will win this match. And he doesn't want Tyson to win this match. He wants to be in his brother's honor. He wants his brother to love him. So he needs to win this match for his brother and for the Saviors. He needs respect if he's going to take over. Which he is kind of taking over by now, because Ryan Blake has been out for quite a while. Anyways, again, he's trying to put him through the cell. What's this? Thought he was going to go for a powerbomb, but no, just a knee to the shoulder. He's just trying to be careful, you know. He wants to put him through the cell, because it's the only way he's going to keep Tyson Frost down. Like, he's not going to hit his finisher and have him, like, stay down for the pin. Like, what would you do if I attacked your wife? And I was trying to pin you. You kick out and you'll try to kick the shit out of me, clearly. Tyson's already kicked the shit out of me. So the next move is obviously just kick out of my pinfalls. And I don't want him to go Super Cena, so I have to do this. But anyways, oh, signature. Oh, he's going to put him through the cell. He's going through the cell. And, wait, what? What was that? Anyways, as you see, put him through the cell. He held on, like I said, smart fighter, smart wrestler. As I said, and now he's just taunting. He's just basically saying he has this. So look at this. He's leading him up. He wants to hit the Sword of Michael, which he's going to do now. And there is the Sword of Michael. Bang. He's done. Tyson. Wait. What's this? He's going to do it again. Oh my God. You're going to break his neck. Don't do. Oh. Oh my God. He did it. A second Sword of Michael, which, man, that's crazy. But one. Oh my God. Did he just kick out of that? He just kicked out of two Sword of Michaels. How? Oh my God. Robert doesn't even know how. No one's ever kicked out of two of those. No one. That's literally one of the most devastating finishers in all of TWF. How could he kick out of two of them in a row? What the? Oh my God. This is crazy. Tyson doesn't want to give up, but look at Robert now. He's just pissed off. He just wants to finish him. He's just like going to hit move after move now. He really wants to finish his match. But look at that. That's terrible. Yikes. Come on, look at this. He's just kicking him. He's just putting his body through so much punishment. And look at that, right off the rope. Well, he kind of hit him there, but he kind of moved as well. So, anyways, there's Tyson with a punch. Oh, another punch, but you've reversed. As I said, Robert's letting him get no control at all. Robert knows that he needs to stay in control to win this match, because if Tyson gets control one more time, he's going to end him. But look at that. Kick up. Nope. And a knee to the stomach. That really hurt. But look, Robert is literally giving no offense at all. Robert is just going super tryhard right now. But look at this. Oh, come back. Nope. Robert, again, he's giving him literally no offense whatsoever. What's that? Baby Web Surprise, Mason H's move. But anyways, no offense whatsoever. No offense whatsoever by Tyson. And oh, a kick right to the face. I can tell you straight up that actually knocked one of Tyson's teeth out. That kick to the face. So Tyson has lost one tooth already. Look at this. What's this? What's he going for? And a headbutt? Some sort of headbutt, ladies and gents. Well, anyways, Robert has been training this new move all week just for Tyson Frost. I don't actually have a name for it, but you're going to see how devastating it is. It's going to plant Tyson Frost's head right into the mat. Tyson Frost, he's not going to kick out after this. He just can't. There's no way he can do it. Maybe he can. But can he hit it? Oh, there he is. And right, oh, a DDT right to the mat. He has been aiming that move up all week for Tyson. But anyways, one, two, three. And Robert Blake wins this one. I'll see you in the next one. Bye.